guys, welcome back to World of Tanks. My name is Bruce and today we take a look at a special topic in World of Tanks, and that is making the right decision at the right time. Many of you out there might ask yourself, how can I improve my gameplay and my win rate? Well, in my opinion, the answer is make better decisions at the right time. So in this video, I want to go through the thought process that is in my head during the game to show you how my decisions influence the game. If you're interested in more reviews and gameplay, go to YouTube and search for World of Tanks with Bruce to get all of my videos, or click on the subscribe button, and now let's go. All right, here we are in the first game. We are on El Halouf in our Reno Gironde. And as I said, in World of Tanks, it's all about making decisions, actually making the right decision at the right time. So the very first decision that we have to make is the position that we want to play. And on El Halouf, in my opinion, the right decision is to go to the C2 position and to play in the brawling area, especially with a heavy tank in a tier 10 and tier 9 game. So that is what we are doing. In World of Tanks, you are basically constantly making decisions, whether those decisions are conscious decisions or unconscious decisions. And the more knowledge you have about armor, about penetration, about view range and spot mechanics and so on and so forth, the more information you have, the better your decisions will be, and the more you will be in a situation to make the right decisions. All right, so the next decision is upcoming, and that is how we want to play this position. We can play aggressively, for example, we can play defensively, and if we take a look at the minimap, we see that most of our team is in the southern portion of the map. Only the T10 and the Emil 2 are going with us as heavy tanks, and the Standard B is also in this position. So the right decision here is to not play too aggressively, but rather to play defensively, to set up a good defensive position. Especially because it looks like we are right now winning the game because we managed, or our team managed, to kill two enemy tanks. So in this situation, in my opinion, it is the right move to stay defensively and to just stay here, be RT safe, and aim at the A lane in order to punish enemy tanks that are making one or the other mistake if they are trying to go to the A1 position. And that is exactly what we are going to do. So nothing more to do. As you could see, the object 432 made its way into this little ditch here, and that is the next point where that triggers my decision-making matrix. I definitely do not want to play aggressively and push down into this little ditch to the object 430U. Why so? Well, because my clip has a clip size of, or a potential damage of approximately 1500, and so this object 430U is not one shot for me. But now he has lost some hit points, so now I can move down into this little ditch and finish him off. But here you go, I just saw, while moving down, I saw that the E75 and also the T57 are also pushing forward, so no chance I can win this engagement against three tanks. So I do need to fall back immediately. And fortunately, I only lost 400 hit points to the T57 because he bounced once. And so fortunately, I stopped my advance and I could fall back and preserve my hit points here. Alright, so obviously we get some support with the Leopard PTA. However, we are still in a situation which is not favorable for us, so we do need to stay defensively. And here you go, the CS59 is making a mistake and I want to punish him. And look at this. 1399 damage because we ammo wrecked him, so we were super lucky. And now it is time to empty our clip and make as much damage as we can on the enemy forces that are advancing. Now my clip is I just emptied my clip, and now what I want to do is I want to preserve my hit points, and this is why I raise my gun slightly, so to hide the little weak spot, this little triangle thing there on my gun, to not get shots on it. And I want to fall back because I do need to take as much time as possible in order to reload my clip. Now, this does not mean that I need to fall back completely, because I can just stay here and bait some shots from the E75 The only thing I need to try to do is to not lose any further hit points. Looks like he is focusing me. And as you can see, in this situation, I wanted to take the shot because I wanted to track him and also make damage. This did not work out. And he got a shot on me, so this trade was actually pretty bad. In my Cromwell video, I talked about three basic steps in World of Tanks, and that is to preserve your hit points, to win or to play important positions, and then to play aggressively when time has come. And right now, time for me has not come. It is only 5-2. However, looks like we will be able to win this position right here. However, I want to reload my clip, and then I can finish off the E75 and also get damage on the T57. Alright, so the E75 is finished off, and now it is time for me to get damage. Nice, and we can finish him off. Unfortunately, the second shot only made 69 damage, but that is alright. And now it looks like we have won the game. Alright, so the T10 is remaining. However, I do not want to get any more damage. This is why I was a little bit hesitant here. He shot at me, I bounced, super lucky. However, we could make another 560 damage on the T10, little high roll here. And now the game is won, and now it is time to play aggressively. We are in a tier 10 heavy tank, and now we have preserved most of our hit points. Yes, we were lucky a little bit, but we still have 1000 hit points, so now it is time to push in aggressively and to try to make as much damage as we possibly can. So I think this is the right decision in at this step of the game. We just move in aggressively, and I mean, you can argue whether it is a very aggressive move if you're driving 40 kilometers per hour top speed, but that is just a limitation that this tank has. So we know basically all the positions. There are only three positions marked on the minimap. So the WT on Panzer 4 is still missing. Here we go, we are spotted. So he is he is on the B0 area. However, we can take a shot from him, and we just want to move forward, keep moving forward. Looks like he is hiding. So in order to make more damage, I want to focus on the FE. He has just shot, so that gives us the opportunity to empty our clip, and his reload is long enough, so we will not fear, so we do not need to fear to take any more damage. All right, perfect. So we went 4,100 damage, and now we just want to keep pressing forward in order to make more damage. Right, we make a shot, we get a shot from the WT on Panzer 4. That is all right. Let's quickly repair our crew, and here you go. Maybe we can get a shot on him. Let's see if we aim in. Nice. And maybe then a second shot. Yep. Nice. We can take this shot, and perfect. All right. So now only two artilleries remaining. We made 4,600 damage, 600 spotting damage, which is super nice result. And I think in the end, we made quite some right decisions at the right time, and that gave us the opportunity to make 4,500 damage in this game. Okay, next game in the Reno Toronto. This time we are in a tier 10 matchup, and I made a video about the Reno Toronto talking explicitly about his about its armor profile. And what you should keep in mind is the armor of the Reno Toronto is fine only if you play hull down. So on a flat surface, the armor is pretty lackluster, so this limits the possibilities that we have on this map. So the first decision is to go into the city but left of the little river, and I think that is a good decision, and we will see this later on in the game. Alright, looks like the 60TP and the Object 277 are coming with us, which is very nice. And we'll see what the EBR 105 is able to spot, and what information he can give us about the location of the enemy team. Okay, looks like the IS-7, alright. Most of the enemy medium tanks are playing the right side of the map, which is fine. And in a second we'll make the first, the second decision. As you can see, the Leopard was spotted there, and he has a crossfire situation on our position. However, so this means that I should not take his shot But rather stay safe behind a building. However, he has just shot, so that gives us the possibility to advance or to keep advancing, and that is the decision I am making right now. So due to the fact that he has just shot, I can use his reload time in order to keep pushing forward. Now there's the next tank that is lit, that is the Foch 155. He has an autoloader gun, but as you can see, there's only 50 meters more for me to travel. So in order to stay here and basically be locked for the next 10 minutes of the game, I want to keep pressing forward. That's the next decision I am taking, because I might take a shot from him, but I will rather take one shot for him and then be safe in the position where I want to fight than to stay here at the at this position and being unable to participate at the game for the next, let's say, 10 minutes. Alright, so as you can see, we take a shot. Unfortunately for us, he did not make any damage, which is super nice. And now the decision is, I could try to go forward to this little, and try to focus the Foch 155 and try to trade shots with him, using my armor and using the rocks there in order to protect me. However, this is not the decision I am taking. The decision that I'm taking is, I was lit the last, let's say, 20 seconds, so I have to consider that artillery is focusing me. So if I stay in this position, I might get shots from the enemy artillery. So instead, I just want to turn my turret towards the Foch 155 so that he cannot get a side shot on my turret. And I want to move Arty safe, and that is exactly what I will do right now. Okay, here you go. Maybe one shot on him. Now I definitely do need to move Arty safe into this position here. As you can see, the Object 277 is brawling with the other heavy tanks, and as I said, the armor of the Reno Geronte is a little bit lackluster for tier 10, so I definitely do not want to brawl with the Object 277 and the 60 TP. I rather want to do what I call second line gameplay, and I made a video about autoloader in which I explained this to you, playing the MX-50B. So my decision here is to play passively, meaning that I only want to peek out once the Object 705 Alpha and the T110E3 have made a shot. So then during their reload time, I want to peek out and see if I can get a shot on them. So let's see how it works. Meanwhile, what we have to keep in mind is that the 60 TP is in our little view range circle here. And let's see, okay, we get pushed by the 60 TP, which is a little bit unfortunate. So this is why we didn't make this shot. Maybe the second one, let's see. Meanwhile, we have enough time to reload our clip. Here you go, and now, all right, perfect. So that was the second, that was another decision I made. I could have stayed behind the wreck in order to empty my clip. However, my decision was to play the Reno Geronte in this situation like a single shot tank, because I want to outplay the enemies, and I do not want to trade hit points with them at this point of the game. So this is why I'm falling back. I will just reload the clip and then once again move out once the enemy tanks have shot, so that I can trade positively in this situation. As you can see, the 60 TP is constantly proxy spotting us, so we don't have the first spot or the first shot advantage. And it looks like the 60 TP is hindering us on doing some reverse side scraping. However, they've just shot, they have fallen back, so we can just stay here, and once they move out of cover, we will have the first shot opportunity, and then once again I will fall back into cover and not trade with the enemies. Looks like the 60 TP is moving towards us. If he moves around the corner, that would be fine, because in the end we have an autoloader with 1500 damage in our clip. 1500 damage that we can do with one clip, that's what I wanted to say. Looks like the enemy T110E3 and the Object 705 Alpha is hiding, and as I'm constantly spotted, the decision that I made right now is I want to signal that I am falling back so that the 60p and maybe also the object 705 alpha have the impression that I am kind of giving up, so they will maybe move out of their cover, and this will then give the 60p the opportunity to get a shot and maybe also ourselves to give a shot. Alright. Now looks like the 705 alpha has moved out of cover. Nice. And now once again I'm waiting for the object 705 alpha to make a shot, and as you can see I'm turning my camera so that I can see the object 705 alpha, and I'm constantly paying attention. Now our 60p has shot. Here you go, 705 alpha has shot, and that is the time for me to move out. Here you go, 60p is making a mistake, and I immediately want to go and take a second shot, and I definitely in an autoloader always want to go for a track shot so that he is tracked, he cannot reverse, and I can take even my third shot even with my inter clip reload of 4 seconds. Obviously I'm now taking the shot. Unfortunately he has moved so that I could not make damage with my third shot, which is super unfortunate. However, I consciously went for the tracking shot, and in this situation there's the decision that I need to make, whether first possibility that I have is to reload my clip and to be in a stronger position in order to brawl. Second decision that I can make is to immediately use the first shot that that I have in my clip in order to try to kill this 60TP, and that is what I want to do, because I think that he is playing aggressively, so we do need to get rid of him. Here you go, together with the 60TP we get rid of the enemy 60TP, and now we do have time to reload. I do have time to reload my clip, which takes approximately 40 seconds, as you know. That's how it is. Alright, so up until this point, the game is almost 5 minutes old. We made 1900 damage and we didn't lose a single hit point because we carefully preserved our hit points. We had a little bit of luck with the Foch 155, yeah, true. However, I think we made smart decisions and this helped us to preserve all of our hit points until this point, which is super nice. And now we have the time in order to reload our clip. Now the 705 alpha has just shot on the 60p, and now that gives us the possibility to move forward and to aim at him. Nice, as you can see, and now he's moving forward, he's playing aggressively, so we do need to make the second shot. And unfortunately, even though we had a green marker, we didn't make any damage, which is unfortunate, but I think that is due to the fact that we have APCR as the first as the silver ammunition, and I was not right in this situation, I was not aware of it. And now the question is, do we empty our clip, or do we wait until we have reloaded maybe the second shell, or maybe until we can use the improved auto loading or reloading mechanism of the Italian heavy tanks. And the decision that I make here is, I want to, at best, the best possibility for me would be to reload the second shell. However, this depends on the movement of the object 705 alpha. So if he moves forward aggressively, I need to stop him. So then I would need to shoot my third shell. If he stops at his position, I would just wait and try to reload my clip in order to get into a better position with having more shots in my clip. And now let's see what he does. Oh, he is tracked. Now the artillery is shooting on him, so he is still tracked. Now he's, I think he used his repair kit, he's moving forward, so now I do need to make the shot. However, due to the improved reload mechanism, I can reduce the reload for the next shell. And now we get help from the Leopard 1, and this gives us the possibility to finish off the 705 alpha. So due to the fact that we got help from the Leopard 1, we could finish off the 705 alpha. Alright, pretty nice. 6 minutes after the game, we didn't lose a single hit point and we made 3200 damage just because we made wise decisions throughout the game. And that is exactly what you have to do in order to improve your gameplay and improve your win rate. In the end, if you preserve your, if you manage to trade positively, play the important positions, and preserve your hit points to the end of the game. There you go, you can finish off the Leopard 1 that is doing a mistake. Then you have more influence at the end of the game, and this will give you the opportunity to win more battles in World of Tanks. In World of Tanks. Alright, so looks like we spotted the enemy units, so we also get some spotting damage. And now there's the next decision upcoming. Looks like the T110E3 is making pressure, and now the decision is, do we take this fight right away, or do we wait? Obviously the right decision is to wait and to fully reload our clip. And then the question is, like, do we want to brawl against him, or do we want to outplay him? And obviously the right decision is to try to outplay him. And so he does not have a turret, so he cannot turn his gun if he would move aggressively towards us. So we can use this, and we can try to use a hole of the building and the wreckage in order to maybe get a side shot once he is advancing. And that is exactly what we want to do here. So we wait until we have reloaded our clip, and then we just use a little hole and wait for him to engage us. As you can see, he moved towards the E100. So this means that now we have to take the next decision, and the decision is to make pressure and to take him out, because we don't want to allow him to finish off the E100 so that we do not have any support in the middle, and then it would be 1 versus 2. So we want to get rid of the T110E3. And now the next decision is to also keep in mind the Foch 155, so we only want to move as forward so that the Foch 155 cannot get a shot on us, but we can get a shot on the T110E3. And that is exactly what we are doing. So, as you can see, he just recognized that we are taking a shot on him, but that is too late for him in order to turn around. And now I want to fall back, because I'm afraid of the Foch 155 that could come around the corner and then empty his clip. And then the problem is, I realize that I have one clip in my magazine, and that is enough to finish him off. However, if that shot would bounce, then my clip would be empty, and I would need approximately 14 seconds in order to reload. And during this time, he could reload all of his clip, and that could be, I don't know, I think 1000 or 1500 hit points that I could lose. So my decision is to fall back and reload the second shot, and thereafter I can play aggressively. That was the thought process I went through in my head, and just now I realized that the E100 had already killed the Foch 155, so this problem is gone, and now it is 3 tanks against 4 tanks. However, we are in a good position basically, because the enemy does have 2 artilleries, and as long as we are keeping that in mind and playing arty safe, those artilleries are not too much of a problem. Right, so the next decision is, what are we going to do? Are we going to follow the TVP T50/51? I think he is trying to go to the enemy cap area and trying to finish off the enemy artilleries. Looks like the T, or we exactly know where the T100LT is. However, the problem is the position of the CS63. Now he has this this weird travel mode, so he can go up to 70 kilometers per hour, and this means that he could actually go towards the T100 position, but he could also go towards the enemy cap and defend the cap. So my decision is to sneak out here and to see whether I get spotted or not. And it looks like I don't get spotted, so chances are that the CS63 has relocated towards the northern part of the area. Right, looks like the TVP spotted the artillery, and looks like the T100LT is moving forward. But I definitely do not want to peek out because of the possibility that the CS63, here you go, now we know where the CS63 is. And we can make pressure on him. Looks like the T100 is trying to play aggressively towards us, and this is a mistake of him, and now we can just move out and finish him off. Okay, once again, we hit the tracks with our APCR. Too bad, and I think this was a game-changing move, because if we had finished him off, then it would be us against the 60, the CS-63 and the artillery, which would be much better. But now we have two tanks against us, plus the enemy does have artillery. So all in all, we are in a very bad situation. And now, the decision that I make is, I want to win this battle, so I want to stay defensively in this position and just have the enemy advance towards me, and then I can use my hit points to trade. Alright, T-100 is moving towards our cap, so let's see, we can finish him off. And once again, yeah, this is now bad luck, and I would call it RNG. So my plan obviously does not work, because the enemy T-100 LT is a smart player, and he's moving towards our cap area because he wants to make some pressure and wants to take me out of the cover. So I do need to react, because once he's in our cap, it is only approximately 2 minutes until he has won the game. So I do need to move out. And can we get RNG this time? Yes. Yes, we can. So we can finish off the T-100 LT. However, we are tracked, and the CS-63 can finish us off. So in the end, it did not work out, but we made 6,200 damage approximately combined. And I think it was a very nice result in the Arena Toronto. And as you could see, making the right decisions at the right time will preserve your hit points and will give you the opportunity to increase your win rate and to outplay the opponents at the end of the game. Alright guys, that was it for today. What do you think about this special topic? Will this video help you out to improve your gameplay? Let me know in the comment section below. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Consider subscribing to my channel, and I see you next time in another World of Tanks video.